Hello friends, welcome to my channel M Square Analysis Projects. So today we will see about triangular element. So let's get started. So first question is, why we use this triangular element? So every problem in the finite is a 3D problem. So we will convert this problem into 2D problem because of its simplicity by using these three different conditions. And also there is one more condition that we have to consider, that what is the efforts required and what is the time required to do this analysis. So we convert this 3D object into 2D. So first condition is a plane stress condition, then second one is a plane strain condition, third one is a axis symmetry. So here in this plane stress condition, so we having a 3D plate which is having thickness and x and y dimensions. So we convert into 2D as we neglect this thickness and convert this, and we do the finite element meshing, that is elements and nodes, to solve the finite element analysis. So similarly in the plane strain condition also, there is a very large thickness, so we will consider as a 2D plane and we will solve this problem by using this element and node numberings and using some software like ANSYS. So in axis symmetry also, all this body is symmetric about this z axis. This is 3D cylinder. So we convert this only cross section we will consider along the edge here. So this cross section here, we convert this into 3D to 2D mesh, and we will solve the analysis, and then we can rotate the results to get the axis symmetry. So while doing the meshing to convert into elements and nodes for this two dimensional, we use such type of a meshing. These are called as a simplex triangular elements. So more about what is mean by simplex, you can click here to for the link. Now for this triangular element, it has three nodes and this is a single element. So we will see the details of this. So it is also called as a constant strain triangle because we have made some arrangement that in this triangular element, the strain inside within this element and at the end points, it is a constant. So strain is constant within the element. That's why it is called as a constant strain triangle. Now for this triangular element, we will consider this as a only one element. Then it has three nodes, 1, 2, and 3. So while giving the numbering, that is node numbering, we use anti-clockwise direction, that is 1, 2, and 3, because it is used in the software. This is the algorithm they are having. So it is noted as a anti-clockwise direction. Each node has 2 degrees of freedom. That means at each node there will be 2 displacement, that is Q1 and Q2 at node 1, Q3, Q4 at node 2, Q5, Q6 at node 6. So displacement we will get for this single element as a 6, and we will get the 3 shape function. At each node there will be 1 shape function. So these are the shape function. It is denoted in the natural coordinate system. N1 is equal to zeta, N2 is equal to eta, and N3 is equal to 1 minus zeta minus eta. This is the constant strain triangle. It is also called as an isoparametric element. So what is mean by isoparametric here? So we can use the same shape function to define this geometry as well as the field variables, that is displacement. Means we can use same formula to find out what is the displacement within this element. Also we can find out the its x and y coordinate using the same formula. That's why this triangular element is called as a isoparametric element. So we will see more detail about this constant strain triangle. So as we seen, this triangular element is used for plane stress, plane strain conditions. So what is the different difference occur in between these two elements, because we are using same element in the both condition, that is in the plane stress and the plane strain. But what is the difference? So difference occurs in material property matrix, that is D matrix. Okay, so that D matrix used in the stiffness. So that is B transpose D into B multiplied by its volume. So this D matrix will differ in the both cases for this triangular element. Also, initial strain conditions means, as this triangular element is used in X and Y plane. So shear strain in the another planes, that is YZ and ZX plane, it will be the zero. These are the initial strain condition. Now what is the difference for this D? So we know plane stress, we will get sigma Z equal to zero, means stress in the third direction will be the zero, and we will get D matrix as this. So there is a derivation we can derive, and we can find out this D matrix. So this material property matrix is used to find out the further process in the ANSYS or in the analysis. While in the plane strain condition, we have epsilon Z is equal to zero, means strain in the third direction is a zero. So for this condition, we will get the material property matrix as this. So there is a derivation also, we can find out this D matrix. So we use same triangular element in this plane strain condition, in this plane strain condition, but there is material property values and the initial conditions are changing. So why we are using this triangular element in this 2D? Because we have to reduce the time required to solve the 3D problem, or we can reduce the efforts required to model the geometry using 3D model. So we convert this into 2D, we use this triangular element, and we will get the deformations, and then we will get the secondary unknowns, that is stress, strain, using these matrices for this triangular element. Thank you.